Let me ask you a question. How do you know you don't have insulin resistance, rotting your arteries, inflaming them, creating plaque? How do you know you don't have cardiovascular inflammation? Well, as John Lorscheider shared with you, he told me in our first visit, I don't have it. My doc's checking it every year. Charles Hancock, old Alabama gardener, very similar story. He had not one, but two really good docs. And they are good docs. They were checking him every year for insulin resistance. They were using a thing called fasting blood glucose. But they missed it. Not only did he decided to go ahead, get an oral glucose tolerance test and do some other testing, and found out that not only did he have insulin resistance or prediabetes, he had full-blown diabetes. Now, why is it that good docs are missing this? Well, I'll talk about that. I'll explain that a little bit more. There's good reasons for it, but I'll do that after the interview clip with Charles Hancock with Old Alabama Gardener. So here was the thing. As he'll share with you in the video, he's had multiple events, heart attacks, and he was continuing to grow plaque. He kept asking his docs why. They said, well, you know, we don't know. Now he knows. So now he's very happy. Now he's doing some things to slow that down. Let's get to the video.
Now, OAG just had some interesting experiences in terms of, your own health, Charles. Can you tell us a little bit about what happened?
Well, I had two artery events where the artery was closing and it required a stent to keep it open. I had that happen twice in 6 months. And so that was very scary, of course. And it was a huge wake-up call for me in that I had to figure out what was causing that and, if possible, change it. Otherwise, I was concerned that I would not survive maybe even the next one. And so I started searching on the internet, and that's how I found your channel. And then through that, I learned that there was a series of tests that I needed to get done. And we can talk about those more in detail if we want to. But so I did those tests, and one of them revealed that I was diabetic, which was a total surprise to me because I just didn't think that I would ever be diabetic.
Yeah, I'm glad you came straight out with that because, again, if you look back at a lot of your videos, it was clear you were aware of diabetes. You knew it was a big health concern for a lot of people. You also had some of your own heart issues going on, but you didn't think that diabetes could have been contributing to yours. You've got a good doc. He had looked at it and he just really hadn't seen anything using the standards of medicine. Is that right?
That's correct. Yeah. And I got a good family doctor and I got a good cardiologist. But they were never able, maybe I didn't press the point hard enough with them, but they were never able to tell me why this was happening to me.
Yeah.
I should say, not only why it's happening to me, but what specifics do I need to do to at least reduce the risk?
Yes. And you see a lot of that on this channel. You see it on a few other channels. If there's one thing I could do to help change medicine in the world today, it would be to help people like yourself. And like many others of us, especially after we get 50 years old, start developing some insulin resistance or prediabetes. We have good doctors. They work hard, but in following the standards of medicine, they don't get the right information, and they quite often misinform us and tell us we don't have to worry. Meanwhile, if you get the right studies, then you find out what was causing the plaque buildup.
And that's, you're right on, because when my blood sugar glucose reading would be 104, 107, fasting blood sugar, my family doctor, that was okay. It was not a concern. He didn't think that was too high. So.
And what study did you get that showed your blood sugar was high?
Well, based on your recommendation, I took a oral glucose tolerance test, OGTT.
Yeah.
Now this, and I it was not something that my family doctor prescribed or suggested I do. This is something I had to do on my own in order to know what was happening with my blood sugar. And I did that test, and the results were absolutely positive that I was diabetic.
Now, why would that happen? Why are good docs missing insulin resistance and even full-blown diabetes on a regular basis for disastrous results? Well, there are several reasons. Standards change. For example, in 1997, the ADA and the federal government said, up until that point, the diagnosis of diabetes was a fasting blood sugar of 140 or higher, or that was one of many ways to diagnose diabetes. Well, at 1997, they dropped it to a 126. A lot of people weren't aware of that, and they knew that that was going to increase the number of people that had full-blown diabetes. Again, when you think about it, by the time you get full-blown diabetes, you've already had a lot of damage done during the pre-diabetes stage. But let's go back to this changing number. This is a population graph for fasting blood glucose. Now, that was the change that happened. And you could see that it increased significantly the number of people that would have a diagnosis of diabetes based on fasting blood glucose when they dropped it from 140 to 126. But look at the rest of this curve, and look at this number 100. We will think about that in just a minute. Well, as you see, if you're looking fasting blood glucose, 100 to 125 is prediabetes. And this one is more accurate. So now think about it. You remember Charles said multiple times, well, my doc kept seeing 104, 105, and he said I was okay. Well, his doc was probably thinking about diabetes, and that was correct. He was okay in terms of diabetes. He didn't need insulin. But meanwhile, he was continuing to irritate, burn the intima, and create plaque and cardiovascular inflammation. Now, here's another. So that talks about maybe shifting diagnoses, thinking about diabetes versus prediabetes. It talks about shifting standards, from dropping from 140 to 124 down to 100. Now, here's another thing. It's the different tests. A1C, fasting plasma glucose, and glucose tolerance tests are all very different tests and very different ways of diagnosing diabetes. His docs kept looking at A1C and fasting plasma glucose. Meanwhile, when we did an oral glucose tolerance test, he came out with a blood sugar over 200. So as you can see, A1C, I have no doubt that the A1Cs were less than 6.5 that his doctors were checking, because A1C's inaccurate over 20% of the time. Anyway, so as you see, there are multiple ways that docs can miss prediabetes and even diabetes. And if both of those are causing risk for heart attack and stroke, it's no wonder that heart attack, stroke, and dementia are the number one killers and disablers in this country. People are going for decades thinking they're fine. Meanwhile, they're burning their arteries. So if you've made it this far, again, as usual, thank you for your interest.